Welcome back, guys. I'm Theo Joe, and today we've got a bunch of really cool free programs I think you're gonna like. And all of them are at least Windows compatible, but some of them might also have versions for Mac as well. And you may have heard of some of them, but I'm sure there are some new ones, at least a few, that you should be excited to learn about. Now, before we begin, I want to give a big thanks to the sponsor of this video, LastPass, which I've actually been using myself for years. If you're not familiar, LastPass is a password manager that securely stores all of your passwords for you, so you only have to remember one master password. And you'll never have to go through the trouble again of looking for forgotten passwords or worrying about being locked out of your accounts. And also, because it has a built-in password generator, you don't even have to spend time coming up with strong passwords yourself. LastPass pretty much puts everything on autopilot, so you don't have to write, remember, or reset your passwords. It keeps track of everything so you can stay sane. Plus, it fills in the passwords on websites for you, so you don't even have to type them in. And like I said, this is the password manager I've always used anyway, so you might consider this a bonus free program in the list, and of course, I'll put a link in the description, so be sure to check that out. And now, let's begin our list of the other 10 free programs we're gonna talk about in this video. Starting off, number one is a program called Recova, which allows you to recover files on your hard drive that you've deleted even if you've emptied the recycle bin already. So the name is like a pun, Recova, recover. Yeah, anyway, the reason this works is when you delete a file on your hard drive or solid state drive, thumb drive, whatever, the file isn't necessarily gone immediately. What actually happens is that block of space the file was taking up has been labeled by the file system as free space, so it can now be used for something else. This means that even after a file has been technically permanently deleted, or what you would consider that, a program like Recova can still look to see if that file is there and potentially restore it. Obviously, the longer it's been since the file's been deleted, the more likely that something has partially or fully overwritten it. So there's no guarantee the file isn't partially corrupted already. But still, there's no reason not to try, and this one has saved me some trouble more than once. Next up, number two. This one is great for anyone who wants a top-notch professional video editor program that is also free, of course. And that is DaVinci Resolve by the company Blackmagic. For a long time, this program has been one of the best color grading softwares out there, even being used on films like X-Men and Tomorrowland, though it was exclusively used for just color grading, not editing. But now, they've completely revamped it and made it into a full-fledged editor as well. There is a paid studio version in addition to the free version, but that just has extra features most people won't care about anyway. Now, as you can imagine, a powerful editor like this has a pretty steep learning curve, but I don't think it's any more difficult than any of the other professional editors out there. It's definitely no Windows Movie Maker, that's for sure. But like I said, if you want something you can eventually use for more complicated projects, this might be the best free option out there. All right, number three. This one is very straightforward. It's called Speccy, and it simply shows your computer's specs. Another pun. Anyway, the thing I like about this one compared to other similar programs is I think it just looks nicer. It has a nice, simple layout, and the information is well organized. The summary page you can see shows basic info about the main components, or you can dive deeper into each on the left, and it will give you more information about your computer than you will ever probably need. But you might also find it interesting, so you can just poke around, check your hard drive health status, for example, or whatever. There's a lot of information to compile in there. Just look at it yourself. Moving on, we have LibreOffice, which is technically a suite of a few programs, but who cares? Actually, I guess I shouldn't say that, because there's definitely someone out there who is very upset I'm counting all of these as one. But anyway, LibreOffice is essentially a free alternative to Microsoft Office, which of course includes Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and so on. I can't imagine it's quite as feature-rich as the whole Microsoft Office suite, but if you're someone like me who only uses the basic features of them anyway, LibreOffice is more than capable. Plus, if you need to, you can open up and save the same file formats that Microsoft Office uses. So the word processor called Writer can open and save .docx files. the spreadsheet program called Calc can open and save XLSX files. The other programs it includes are Impress, which is like PowerPoint, Base, which is like Access for databases. Then it also has a drawing program and one for writing math formulas. And yes, by the way, this is all cross-platform, so if you've ever used Ubuntu, you know that this comes preloaded as the editors. So yeah, it's definitely worth checking out if you don't want to pay Microsoft subscription now or pay a whole bunch of money if you don't even use it that much. All right, number five is pretty interesting. It's called Bulk Rename Utility. And if you can't figure out what it does based on the name, well, I think you need to go back to school and finish the first grade. But yeah, it basically just allows you to rename a bunch of files at once in different ways. And you probably won't appreciate how useful this program is until you need it. Now, when you open up this program, you're definitely gonna be overwhelmed, thinking, what the heck am I looking at? Because it sure ain't pretty. But it's really not so bad because it simply has all the options laid out in front of you, and clearly there are a lot of options. So say you have a bunch of files and all of them with different names, and you just want to add a prefix to the beginning of all of them. Well, there's a section where you can do just that. Or maybe you need to change all the files from uppercase to lowercase, or even make the first letter of every word uppercase. Yep, you can do that too. Or maybe you need to number all the files starting at 37 and remove three characters from the center of every file name while moving the first five letters to the end and changing the file extension. Yes, you can do that as well. Never thought renaming files could be so complicated, huh? Okay, on to number six, Discord. Put very simply, it's a VoIP program where you can talk with others using text chat, voice, and video. But its features extend way beyond that. The main idea is you can set up Discord servers that are either private or public, and within each server, you can set up separate channels or rooms, kind of. So one use might be that you set up a server for you and all your friends, and maybe they want to do voice chat and play different video games. Those who want to play one game can go in one channel and another game the other. It also lets you share files and images right in line with the chat. And yes, it's free to set up servers, and you can customize them quite a bit. You can have different permissions for moderators and set them for different people, make some channels restricted, add custom emoticons, a whole bunch of stuff. Plus, it has an overlay that supports basically any game, so you don't have to alt-tab out of full screen to chat. Obviously, there's way more to it, but you can check the rest out for yourself. Next up, we have RainMeter. This is a classic. It's an awesome program for customizing your computer's desktop. You can download different plugins called skins, which are kind of like different widgets, and they just sit on your desktop and do stuff. So they can do anything from showing you the current system volume to current RAM usage or the weather, or act as links to different programs and sites, really anything you can think of. There are thousands of plugins with all sorts of designs out there made by all sorts of different people. And there are a few sites that aggregate RainMeter skins like DeviantArt, so you'll just have to search through them yourself. There's no way I can even scratch the surface right now, but it shouldn't take you long to find a few things you like or even make up your own skins. Number eight, this is a really simple program called Media Info. And well, it shows you all sorts of info about media files, imagine that, particularly audio and video. For example, you can right-click a video file, hit Media Info, and it will bring up a window with all sorts of stats about that file. The bitrate of the video, what kinds of video codecs it uses, what audio streams it has, the resolution, the frame rate, even what chroma subsampling it uses, for those of you who know what that is. It's not something you'll probably use every day, but it can be useful. Like if you download some videos you want to convert to smaller files, it might help to know what the current bitrate of the video is, so you know how much to change it to reduce the size. Or maybe you're watching a movie and it looks choppy for some reason. You can see if maybe whoever encoded the video made the frame rate too low, or if it just has a huge bitrate that your computer isn't able to handle. So I'm sure that anyone who can actually use this one probably gets the idea by now. Coming near the end, number nine, MP3 tag. You can kind of think of this one like the bulk rename utility, except MP3 tag is specifically designed for changing and fixing the metadata for music files. I'm sure everyone has experienced a time when they import a bunch of music into iTunes or whatever music program, and some stuff is either completely missing info, whether it's the titles or artists or albums, or it's all just wrong. With this, you can go in and change any of the tags for however many files at once. You can also do cool stuff like setting the tags based on the file names. So maybe all the info is in the file names, but there are no metadata tags, so the music programs don't know. With this, you can tell the program what part of the file names to use as the title, artist, and so on. Or you can do the reverse and change the file name based on the tags to standardize everything to your liking. Maybe not something that everyone will need, but for those of you that do, I think this will be very helpful. And finally, one of my personal favorites, Flux. Maybe you've heard me talk about this before, but Flux automatically adjusts your computer's monitor's colors and brightness at night in such a way so it's less likely to mess up your sleep. I think by now everyone knows that looking at a computer screen or phones and televisions can make it harder to fall asleep. And scientifically, this is because these devices produce lots of light in the blue wavelength part of this light spectrum, which your brain thinks is sunlight, which is the same color. What Flux does is remove this blue light from the screen and makes it look a little bit more orange. And interestingly, a couple minutes after the screen color changes, you'll probably not even notice the difference because your eyes adjust. And if you've been using it for a while and then you disable it at night, you'll feel like you're just getting blinded by the screen. It's kind of funny, like no wonder you couldn't sleep before. It's pretty crazy, you'll see immediately. And this is definitely one I think literally everyone should use and check out. So that's it, 10 really neat free programs you'll hopefully find useful. You can let me know if you have any suggestions of your own down in the comments. And if you want even more free programs, you can look over here. I'll put a thing to my last video you can just click on. And if you want to subscribe, I make a few new videos every single week and also enable notifications, or YouTube probably won't even show you the new videos in the first place. But anyway, looking forward to hearing from you either here or on Twitter and Instagram. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.